Then our work here is complete, and I can return to Council Tower. She hands you a pouch. The city of Sega's Cliffs owes you its gratitude. We got 150 shins. We're getting rich over here. And we gained an Ebon Eyes. I will credit you in my report to the council. Get back here. I need help from you. Okay, so... yeah, we've got positive fennel. Temporary conditions that affect character stats and actions. Flex skill. Huh? Increases the jack skill level in a chosen skill. Plus one training level and persuasion skill. I'm not a jack. Beg your pardon. So we are dominant tides gold and blue. Cool. Oh, right, I gotta give him this again since we restored. Alright. So I hope they fix this thing. I'm not gonna wanna use it. And I can't put it in regular inventory. The only thing I can do is keep it there, use it, or discard it. So, not gonna discard it. Talking about the fresh vapors. That has 5 actions and... I don't know. Maybe I used it by mistake a few times? I'm not even sure.
You were wearing just a smile? And she let you pass?
We've heard that one before.
Of course. It paid my toll, as it were. Many times over.
But... where were you keeping her money? In your mouth?
So to speak. So to speak.
Which mouth? Different orifice? So I want to go up to the council and see if they'll help me with the whole Eretus thing. She didn't seem that happy with me. But it could have been worse. Government Square we want. We can't go directly there, can we? We can go there from Cliff's Edge. At least I think we can. I wish I knew how long this lasts for. Maybe all day, and then we just activate it again? That's pretty cool. I'm guessing if we undo it, like unequip it, the effect will go away. That's what I'm thinking. Wouldn't make sense otherwise. Government Square, yes.
I'm ready. I'm always ready.
I'm sure you are.
I'm ready.
Off to the council. Oh, we can level him up, Eretus. Well, I actually hope this persuasion lasts a while. Because that will be, useful. Let's increase his intellect. Everything else is so high, might and speed. Let's see. Oh, we can't? I can't. Alright. Let's hope it would help his willpower. Saves in battles. Increases health by 1. Just 1? Let's take another speed. Okay, another point remaining. Another might then, I guess.
Stories will be told of this day.
Yes, when you increase 2 of your stat pools. That's awesome.
I'm ready.
Alright.
I'm always.
Yeah. We need to talk to him. I don't think there's anyone else we can talk to about this. Mimivir is in the blue. Paperwork. Do you have any records about someone named Zeb? Zeb? One moment, the clerk mutters, shuffling papers in and out of the portals. I don't remember who Zeb is. He skims them with one eye. His other eyes turn to the council work that does not pause, or even slow. Yes, rather typical, really. A birth certificate, some reports from the Levies, a notation in a creditor's lien. You should be able to find him over in Cliff's Edge with his sister Nim. The mother's dead. The father's a throat cutter for the Memorvira. The Levies have it right. Oh, that kid? Didn't we leave him? Didn't he go through the portal of the House of Endless Time or whatever? So blue and gold tide raise a tiny amount. He eyes you for a moment, reading something on your face. I can't fathom what you were expecting. There's nothing more. It's hardly a common name, though to be sure the child has a common enough lot. Come back in a few years and I'm sure there will be a magistrate's judgment against him, if not a death certificate. There's nothing about Zeb in older records of the city's past? You're expecting him to appear in the past as well? I'm guessing this has something to do with that gate around the corner. Unfortunately, the answer is no. I have no record of the boy in the past, so clearly that is not where he went. You mentioned a Memorvira? The clerk scowls without looking up. Some builders raise monuments of marble. Others tear the monuments down, cook the marble to lime, mix the lime with the concrete, and use the concrete to make hardened bunkers. He shakes his head. Organizations can be made the same way. And people. The Memorvira has demolished many things, and from the rubble has built an impenetrable organization of hardened souls. You would be wise to keep your distance. An eye glances your way. But you don't look wise. Can you tell me anything else about loss of self? The clerk shakes his head. Only that she was born in Sega's Cliffs, and that at one time her family filed a report that she was missing. He frowns. If the city has lost all record of this woman, then her identity is a secret indeed. I need that certificate of indemnity for Aratus. As I said before, the clerk replies, that is not in my power to give. Is there someone powerful who could arrange matters for you? I hope the council member named Crispus Horatius find a missing cipher. Pellii will help me. Gold tide, very small amount. The clerk shrugs. I suppose she has the discretion to authorize such relief, provided she can find a suitable justification. He scribbles a message down and sends it off through the portal. A reply returns with admirable speed, and you can see from the inelegant script that it was dashed off by a hurried hand. Ooh, we got one. We got one certificate of indemnity. Whereas, assuming law and equity, the clerk mutters. He lays the sheet down, embosses it with the lesser seal of Sega's Cliffs, then passes it to you. It is a certificate of indemnity, assuring Renio that he can collect any damages from the city's treasury. It seems Pellii found adequate justification.
Making a note.
Now, is there something else you need, or can I return focus to my work? Farewell. Happy? We're gonna return to him now. Let's return to Caravanserai. Love that name for some reason. Mr. Renio! This should complete this quest as well. I'm sure you guys noticed I've been trying to, you know, wrap everything up before we continue on with the main quest. It's kind of the things I like to do in games. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Wrap up all the loose ends before you continue on. And he is way up here.
Above. Sideways.
Well, if you're yelling to Master Renio, it's... Look out below. Hail, Renio. My vessel will remain grounded until the thief responsible for stealing my other airship has made me whole. Are you ready to discuss terms for your thieving friend? What will you offer? Hand him the you know what? I want to look at this thing. Like, can I read this? This certificate is signed and sealed by the city of Sagas. It attests the willingness of the city to assume the debts Eretus incurred in his airship crash. This should be sufficient to resolve the dispute between him and Renio. Oh, nothing surprising.
I'll remember
here.
That.
You pass a certificate of indemnity you got from the council clerk to Renio. He takes the document gingerly, as though expecting it to bite, and reads it, lips moving silently. They freeze mid-word. He thinks, impossible. Imposible. Gold Tide raises a small amount, and we got 40 XP. Compensation for any and all damages? He quotes. How in the world did you... Never mind. He waves his hands. This is magic. I don't want to know how the trick was done. He eyes you with a great tenderness. Thank you. You've saved my family's business. And with that uncertainty out of the way, I'll be resuming flights to the Valley of Dead Heroes shortly. Ooh, I wonder if he can tell us there. Definitely gotta remember him. Valley of Dead Heroes. Alright, farewell. He's not gonna react at all here. Nope. Okay. We just helped him a tremendous amount.
Great deal.
Sorry, a great deal. I said I had an itch on my ear. So... Wow. Good job. This I can't figure out yet. Maybe hopefully later. And Mother Tamaz is missing. So the only thing left is go back to Underbelly. Which... Look at that. The Cave of Last Words. I think that's where we need to go. Of course, we can't go there from here. But we can go down to Cliff's Edge.
In this world, then.
Yes, Cliff's Edge in this world, as opposed to another one.
Here comes the Boredom Slayer!
Mm. See, this must be it. Yeah, leave area. They're all running around trying to figure out how to get there. Where are they going? Ha ha ha. Okay. Yeah, we can't go there. Nice try. I was waiting for you must gather your party before venturing forth type of message. Okay.
Why not?
Why not? Back down to the underbelly. She's not there, Rin. Damn it. I hated leaving her go. That really sucked.
In an instant.
It sucked in an instant.
Go.
Now, where did we leave this automaton? Did it go back? I'm assuming it went back to Underbelly. I didn't bother checking last time. back to the collapsed tunnel? Stika incursion. I don't remember it saying that. I will... Yeah, here it is.
I'm ready. I'm always ready.
You sure are. Now, I don't have a lot of... Is this intellect? I don't have a lot of intellect right now. Too bad we can't just rest down here. Oh, area map? Yeah, that is the map I know. Character sheet. Isn't there a rest button or something? I thought there was, I just don't remember where it is. Those abilities. Items. No. Yeah, I don't know. Alright. We'll continue on then. I want you to dig a tunnel to take me somewhere. Start digging in a random direction. I think we tried that. Take me to the Cave of Last Words. I missed the words that popped up after that.
Who are you?
Haha, you are Matkina. This woman's skin is white, the color of alabaster or fresh ivory. Flat, black eyes surrounded by sharply pointed features stare coldly at you. She wears jet black hair cut straight at the shoulders. Her clothes are functional and drab. Her cloak is fastened by a necklace of 5 canisters, each of a different shape. She turns a black device over and over in her hands.
Where did you come from? How did you know where to find me?
Her startled expression becomes a dark glower. A keen blade flickers through her fingers. You're sure it wasn't there a moment ago? And she thinks, Did I invite her here? No. I wouldn't have done that. Okay, so I'm not the only one who doesn't remember things I do. Callistes leans in close to you. I wouldn't have thought it possible, but it appears we have found someone even more paranoid than poor Allegern. I followed your trail. Silver Tide. Skist. Thought I'd covered it. Thought I'd covered my tracks. Thought... Fine. You wanted to find me? You found me. More's the pity. So now it's time to talk. Wait, are you asking the questions here? Or am I? She glances at your tattoo. How new are you? What were the circumstances of your birth? When did you happen? I was born as my body fell from an exploding moon. More Silver Tide. Ha! That bastard of a creator always finds his way to abandon us at the worst possible moment. Have you heard the stories of Tuck? Or Inifir yet? You should. What of them? She points her chin at your companions. If you think you can overpower me with mortals, you're mistaken. Callistia says, oh, she is fascinating, isn't she? A wicked smile crosses her lips. What did you say? You're trespassing in my home, you know. Coming with a cast-off makes you more suspicious, not the other way around. Trust me, we mean no harm. Gold Tide. I don't trust you. That's the problem. But fine. She flicks her hand, and the knife disappears. Disemboweling you would just be a waste of time for me anyway. She turns back to her workbench and picks up the device again. Then she spits on the floor and scuffs it with her boot, all nervous energy. So what do you want from me? What can you tell me of other castoffs? Self-absorbed, treacherous, leave a trail of misery and suffering. Shall I continue? Also powerful, scheming, ambitious. Her smile is crooked and quick. But you want names, don't you? She barks a laugh that's half a sob. You won't get them from me, though. Not now. I remember Adaris, and I remember the First, and I remember Tash. And I killed Tash for what he did to me, for the hole he cut in my memory. But that hole grew and grew, and... Her eyes flicker, and her cold gaze returns to you. This is more than you need to know. They're bastards, all of them. You as well. Why are you hiding down here? I'm not hiding. Her rage is quick, hot, and palpable, and something about it makes your vision dim for a moment. I'm strategizing, planning. Why would someone live voluntarily in a place like this? She gestures around her, and as her eyes break contact with you, her emotion leaks from her frame. This is where I stay. It's a bolt hole. Always has been. For those who know where to find it. Even Chilla hid there. Here, they say. What are you planning? Oh, were you a part of my plan? You weren't. It's not your business. I heard you might know who can repair a device I found in the reef. Something called a resonance chamber. The resonance... A glint of understanding shines in her eyes. Ah, yes. Of course he would have hit it there. A crooked grin plays about the corner of her mouth and then vanishes. I know who can help you. Or did. She shakes her head. It slips away. My mind has holes in it. Tash took a rusty scalpel to my thoughts, my memories. I can't... She trails off. She catches hold of the table, and it seems to anchor her. Her eyes harden.
Making a note.
No. No, you must do something for me. She caresses the black and jagged device, knobbed and protruding with antenna. A sigil, reminiscent of your tattoo, is emblazoned on it. This is Tash's mirror caster. I want you to enter his mirror and find out what you can about the jack. I'm convinced. I'm convinced that's the key. What is a jack? You don't know? I thought it was a common instrument. No. No, it might not be so much anymore. One of the curses of a long life. Fashions come and go before you even know they exist. Probably easier just to let them go and make new ones of your own, like some of the other cast-offs. Sorry. No, not sorry. You should know this. You should know about things. History. That's what life is. Knowing and doing. Matkina, you need to focus. Tell her what she needs. A jack is an ancient woodwind, and this one was kept in a sealed cave behind massive doors from a prior world. It had powers, but I can't remember what those powers were. What's a mirror caster? Huh. Am I really the first one to say the word to you? Oh, you're in for a surprise, sweet sister. Every cast-off has one. Just like every cast-off has this. She taps the tattoo on your head. No one knows what they're for. Adaris used to think they were a byproduct of the transfer process, just like us. She seems lost in a thought for a moment. Then she shakes her head. Wherever they came from, they can't be used like a kind of temporal viewer. They can be used, sorry. Like a kind of temporal viewer. You relive an event in the life of the cast-off, whose mirror caster it is. That event is called a mirror. It's a byproduct of the transfer process, at least that's what they used to tell me. Regardless of what it truly is, you can use it to relive an event in the life of another cast-off. Can a mirror caster be used to spy on other cast-offs? Not spy, more like seeing pictures of their past, like watching them from inside their minds at times when they burned or raged or changed when their life was at a moment of flux. Why can't you enter the mirror? Don't you think I've tried? She snarls with sudden rage, her knife a handspan from your neck. Nice. I thought you put that away, lady. Do you think I would waste my time with a newborn, a thief who steals into my home, if there were any chance I could do this myself? Her shoulders heave up and down with each angry breath. I try, and my mind fills with static, like I'm talking to a Murden. Only it slashes and stabs and burns me, and... She thinks, I can't. I can't. It'll only make things worse. Maybe it has already. She blinks then, confused. Why am I angry? Did you... She straightens, flipping the knife back into her cloak. No. It'll be all right. Just find the damn Jack, and I'll tell you whatever you need to know. If the Jack is a key, what does it unlock? Her brow furrows, confused for a moment. She curses. If I knew that, I wouldn't need your help, would I? He stole that memory from me, all right? If you could find it for me, it will all come back. All of it. How do I enter a mirror? An almost palpable hunger fills her eyes, a yearning. Hold the mirror caster. You will feel the tug immediately. Don't resist. Empty your mind and let the tides pull you into the mirror caster. She collects herself. Then just watch him. Watch for the Jack. When you see what he's done with it, pull your mind away from Tash's and tell me what you saw. Oh, and don't try to change anything, she says, almost as an afterthought. Why shouldn't I try to change anything in the mirror? What do you mean by that? Nothing serious, she says it as though speaking to an overly concerned child. She laughs suddenly. It's not like you can change the past, but I need you to learn a specific piece of information. If you change something, then you might go the wrong way. I'll do it. I'll enter the mirror for you. She plucks Tasha's mirror caster from the table. She looks at it, at you, and back at the device. She licks her lips as if weighing her options, and then, before she can hesitate any more, slaps it into your hands. It's surprisingly heavy. Do it, she says, her voice heavy. Find the Jack. Bring me the answers. You focus on the device, and you feel something tugging at your mind. Here we go.